We're so glad that Keri is here with us, with Cowboy Celtic, with Dave and Denise and Joe. Keri is a very versatile musician, playing so many styles, everything from cowboy music to chamber music. These people are also talented. Wow, I feel way incompetent being up here with them. I don't know how I ended up on this show. How does one mentally, Keri, adjust to playing with Cowboy Celtic one night and possibly with a symphony on the next?
I do that. And sometimes I joke about I'm the only person that goes from the concert hall downtown to the pub all in the same day. Quick costume change sometimes, you know. Throw on the boots. But yeah, it is, it's a completely different way of looking at music. And I wanted to mention too, Richard still does some orchestral playing as well. It's kind of, it just keeps you really mentally alert, and it's a, you still have a boss in charge when you're at the symphony or when you're with Cowboy Celtic. Dave doesn't have, you know, the baton to point at me if I do something wrong.
What inspired you to start playing the harp?
Celtic music. I played, again, like Richard, I started playing classically as a pianist when I started when I was 5 years old and studied all the classical conservatory repertoire, and then I got interested in Celtic music and wanted something to accompany my singing that was a little more Celtic than piano, and I tried accordion. That was not as ethereal, shall we say. So, and the harp is set up very much like the piano, so it was not an easy transition, but much easier than if I tried to play a bowed instrument.
Nice. Have you ever been tempted to toss in a little Cowboy Celtic during a chamber music performance, just to see if anybody would notice or pick up on
Sometimes it? I accidentally throw in Celtic ornamentation when I'm playing Celtic, like classical music. Yeah, so it happens.
Do they notice? Or?
Yeah, or sometimes I start writing a chord chart over top of my symphony charts. So that happens too.
Well, I think, and I'm sure everyone here today agrees, that the harp produces some of the most beautiful sounds that have ever been created. And we'd love to hear you play a tune on the Celtic harp.
Sure, and this one is a special request from Scot, so I switched my selection. This is, on my CD, this is Merle Travis's Dark as a Dungeon. So, and it's, just to show how Celtic he was, I put it together with a Turlough O'Carolan tune. That's a tune that's over 300 years old, and Turlough O'Carolan was the famous blind harper of Ireland. So he used to tour around, and in exchange for food and lodging, he would write a tune for the family he was staying with. So I think that's like kind of a nice career line. I should look into that. So this is called She Beg, She More, and Merle Travis's Dark as a Dungeon. Together, like they were always meant to be.